Welcome to a video on average cost, revenue, and profit functions and their derivatives. The goal of this video will be to find the average cost, revenue, and profit functions, and also to find the derivative of the average profit function, also known as marginal average profit. If C of X is our cost function, and X is the number of items, C of X divided by X will give us our average cost function. If R of X is our revenue function, and again, X is a number of items, R of X divided by X will be our average revenue function, and if P of X is equal to our profit function, P of X divided by X will be our average profit function. The notation for average cost, revenue, and profit can be as follows. Sometimes they'll use C bar of X or A sub C of X for average cost, R bar of X or A sub R of X for average revenue, and P bar of X or A sub P of X for average profit function. Now remember, the derivative measures a rate of change. So if we want to know the rate at which the average cost, revenue, or profit are changing at a specific value of X, we just need to find the derivative of the average functions and evaluate at a specific value of X. Here we see the notation used for the derivatives of the average functions. The derivatives are often called marginal average cost, marginal average revenue, and marginal average profit. Let's go ahead and take a look at an example and apply this. Palo Verde Nursery finds that the cost in dollars of growing X hundred mesquite trees is given by this cost function. If the revenue from sales of X hundred trees is given by this revenue function, we want to be able to find the following, the average cost, average revenue, and average profit functions when X hundred mesquite trees are grown. And then we want to find the rate at which the average profit is changing when 1,000 mesquite trees are being grown. Remember, this is really the key. If our derivative is positive, we'll know that selling additional trees will increase revenue. If our derivative is negative, then if we sell additional trees, we will be decreasing our average profit. Let's start by finding our average functions. So here we want to find the average cost function. So we're going to take C of X and divide by X. Now notice when I rewrote C of X, I rewrote the fourth root of X as X to the 1/4 power. Now since I am dividing by a monomial, I am allowed to rewrite this as two separate fractions. If I move this factor of X up into the numerator, it's going to change the exponent to a negative 1. So this would simplify to 200 X to the power of negative 1 plus 100 X to the power of negative 3/4. Now I can obtain this two ways. I can take this exponent of 1/4 and subtract 1, or if I move this up and it becomes X to the power of negative 1, I could add it to the 1/4. Either way, I'm going to get a power of negative 3/4. This is our average cost function. Let's do the same for our revenue and profit. Again, notice I changed the square root of X to X to the power of 1/2. Again, I'm dividing by a monomial, so I'll break it up into two fractions. And I'll take this one more step. I'd have 120 X to the power of negative 1 plus, again, I can look at this two ways. I can take this power of 1/2 and subtract the 1 to get a negative 1/2. Or again, if you think of moving this up, it would be X to the negative 1, and then you'd add the negative 1 to the 1/2 to get a negative 1/2. So here we have our average cost function, and here we have our average revenue function. Well, since we already have these, in order to find the average profit function, we know that profit is equal to revenue minus cost, so the average profit would be equal to the average revenue minus the average cost. So we'll go ahead and do it that way. We'll take 120 X to the negative 1 plus 90 X to the negative 1/2, and we'll subtract our average cost. Now when we combine these, we do have two like terms here, so the result would be negative 80 X to the power of negative 1 plus 90 X to the power of negative 1/2. And notice we're subtracting this quantity, so we're going to have minus 100 X to the power of negative 3/4. Okay, so we found all three average functions. Let's go ahead and take a look at part B, which is actually the calculus part of the question. Now we want to find the rate at which the average profit is changing when 1,000 mesquite trees are being grown and sold. Well, in order to find the rate of change, we're going to have to find the derivative of the average profit function. So let's go ahead and do that. Since it's in this form, we can just go ahead and apply the power rule. If we left it in the original form, p of x divided by x, we'd have to use the quotient rule. So the derivative of the average profit function would be, now again, multiply by negative 1, and then subtract 1. Negative 1 minus 1 would be negative 2. Plus, I'll write this one out. We have 90 times a negative 1 half, x to the power of negative 1 half, minus 1, minus 100 times negative 3 fourths, x to the negative 3 fourths, minus 1. So let's clean this up. 90 times negative 1 half would be negative 45, so write minus 45, x to the negative 1 half minus 1 would be negative 3 halves. Here we have negative 100 times a negative 3 fourths, that would be a positive 75. X to the 3 fourths minus 1 would be negative 7 fourths. So now we just have to evaluate this derivative. We need to be a little careful here. The original question stated x was in the hundreds. So since it takes 10 one-hundredths to make 1,000, we want to evaluate this derivative when x is 10, not 1,000. This would be fairly challenging to do without a calculator, so let's go ahead and go to the graphing calculator. And what I've done to evaluate this is I've typed in this derivative into y1, and then I'll use the table feature to evaluate it. So if I hit second graph, I can just type in the x value that I desire, which is 10. So the value of the derivative is approximately 2.13. So what does this mean? Well, first off, it's positive. So that means when x is 1,000, average profit is increasing, which is a good thing. And in fact, if we sell one more tree, we can expect $2.13 more cents added to our average profit. So $2.13 is our marginal average profit when x is equal to 1,000. In general, if the marginal average profit is positive, the average profit would be increasing. If the marginal average profit is negative, the average profit would be decreasing. That's not a good thing. Average profit is generally maximized when the marginal average profit, remember the derivative of the average profit function, is zero. Let's take a look at this graphically. In blue, we have our average profit function. Remember, the derivative gives us the slope of the tangent line. And you can see by looking at this profit function, this point right here looks like the highest point on that function, which is where our average profit would be the highest. And if you drew a tangent line right there, you can see that the slope of this tangent line would be zero. Therefore, the derivative would be equal to zero at that point. This reinforces the idea that where the derivative of the average profit function is equal to zero, we most often will have a maximum. And we can see that it occurs somewhere around, looks like 33, so that would be 3,300 mesquite trees, with a maximum average profit of $6 per tree. I hope that helps you find the average revenue, cost, and profit functions, as well as the marginal average cost, revenue, and profit functions. Thank you for watching.